The Rio Sonoyta Pupfish, a native to the Sonoran Desert. Like many of the creatures that inhabit this land, they are able to survive in harsh conditions. They live in freshwater ponds and streams. Pupfish are naturally inquisitive and very protective of their homes. When defending their territory and wooing females, male Rio Sonoyta pupfish change color, becoming a vibrant blue. These fish are small but resilient. They can withstand temperatures up to 113 degrees Fahrenheit, low dissolved oxygen content, and waters twice as salty as the sea. The biggest one ever recorded was 1.6 inches long. The springs, lakes, and marshes of the Sonoran Desert were once homes for these resilient fish. Historically, their habitat ranged from northern Mexico to the lower Colorado River in Arizona, and even into California. Presently, they only exist naturally in just two bodies of water: the Rio Sonoyta in Mexico, and the Quito-Baquito Springs in southern Arizona. In the 1970s, scientists from the U.S. and Mexico recognized that the pupfish were losing their habitat. Groundwater pumping, water pollution, habitat loss, and the introduction of exotic and competitive fishes led to the population decline of the desert pupfish. They were listed as an endangered species in 1986. To combat the loss of this species, a population was rescued from the Rio Sonoyta in Mexico. Since then, the pupfish have been transported by scientists to multiple ponds to ensure their survival both in Mexico and the United States. This population of pupfish now lives at the Desert Research Learning Center in Tucson, Arizona. Operated by the National Park Service, the Desert Research Learning Center features an artificial tanaha, or bedrock pond, where the pupfish are currently thriving. Humans have more influence over their ecosystems than any other species on the planet. As more people move to the Sonoran Desert, more water is required to meet our needs, especially for agriculture. Water depletion negatively impacts all living creatures within the Sonoran Desert and beyond. We share much in common with the living things around us. Just as the desert pupfish can't survive without clean water, neither can we. There are many ways we can reduce the amount of water we use. To find out more, do an online search for water conservation. Every one of us is capable of making changes to help protect our environment and wildlife. When we conserve resources, we not only help the most small and vulnerable species, but we also help ourselves. To learn more about the Rio Sonoyta pupfish, visit the website of the Arizona Game and Fish Department and follow the link to Native Fish Management.